the topic we are going to discuss is the combination of resistors. There are two possible ways that a resistor is connected in the circuit. First one is the series combination, second one is the parallel combination. First we are going to discuss the series combination. This is the circuit diagram for series combination of resistor. There are three resistors that are connected in series. In series combination, resistors are connected end to end and electric current has a single path through the circuit. This means that the current passing through each resistor is same. This is the battery, positive terminal and the negative terminal. The total voltage in series circuit divides among the individual resistors, so the sum of the voltage across the resistance of each individual resistor is equal to the total voltage supplied by the source. We can write it as V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. From Ohm's law, V is equal to IR. We know that V is equal to IR. From this, we can write as V1 is equal to IR1 plus V2 is equal to IR2 and V3 is equal to IR3. By taking I common from this, V is equal to IR1 plus R2 plus R3. I is multiplying here and divided on the other side of the equality. V over I is equal to R is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. This is the sum of three resistors, so we can write it as equivalent resistance. This is the relation for three resistors. We can generalize it as R equivalent is equal to R1 plus R2 plus so on Rn. The next topic is parallel combination. This is the circuit diagram for parallel combination of resistors. There are three resistors connecting in the parallel and the voltage current in each resistor will be different due to the different values of the resistance, and the voltage across three resistors will be equal to the total voltage of the battery. The advantage of parallel combination is that we can independently on and off any resistor, and the total voltage of the battery is supplied among all the resistors. The voltage in each resistor supplied by the battery will be equal to the total voltage of the battery. These two advantages of the parallel combination of the resistors. In parallel combination, one end of each resistor is connected to the positive terminal of the battery while the other end of each resistor is connected with the negative terminal of the battery. Voltage is same across each resistor, which is equal to the total voltage of the battery. So we can write it as V is equal to V1 is equal to V2 is equal to V3. The current flowing through the circuit is divided among all the resistors. The total current is equal to the sum of current in various resistances. I is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. Since the voltage across each resistor is V, so by Ohm's law, I is equal to V over R. For differentiation, we can write it as I1 is equal to V over R1, I2 is equal to V over R2, I3 is equal to V over R3. We can write the values in this equation. I is equal to V over R1 plus I2 is equal to V over R2, I3 is equal to V over R3. By taking V common from this, we can write as V is equal to 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2 plus 1 over R3. V is divided on the other side of the equality. I over V is equal to 1 over R is equal to 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2 plus 1 over R3. The combined effect of all the three resistors is equal to R equivalent. This is the relation for three resistors. For n number of resistors, we can generalize it as 1 over R equivalent is equal to 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2, so on 1 over Rn. Parallel circuits have two advantages over series circuits. Each device is in the circuit receives the full battery voltage. Each device in the circuit may be turned off independently without stopping the current flowing to the other device in the circuit. This principle is also used in household wiring. The topic is electrical energy and Joule's law. The statement for electrical energy and Joule's law is: Joule's law can be stated as the amount of heat generated in a resistance due to the flow of charges is equal to the product of square of current I, resistance R, and time duration T. We can discuss it as we know that turbines run generator to produce electrical energy. when water falls on it from higher gravitational potential to the lower gravitational potential. Similarly, when charges move from higher electric potential to the lower electric potential, it delivers electric current. Heat always flows from hot body to the cold body. It continues to transfer as both the ends are on equal temperature. Thus, the process during which charges continuously move from higher potential to the lower potential becomes a continuous source of electrical energy. Consider we are considering two points with a potential difference of V volt. If 1 coulomb of charge is passing between these points, the amount of energy delivered by the charge would be V joule. We can write the relation electric potential is equal to work done per unit charge. This is the electrical energy work done, that is equal to potential into charge. As we discussed earlier, electric current is equal to charge divided by time. So by rearranging it, Q is equal to IT. Putting the value of Q in this equation, W is equal to Q is equal to IT, putting value IT, and this is the voltage V. So this is the relation for Joule's law, or you can say that mathematical form of Joule's law. We can change it, rearrange it from using Ohm's law, that is equal to V is equal to IR. We are going to put the value of V over here. W is equal to IR, IT. The value of V is equal to IR, I and I square, R and time. So another form, W is equal to I square RT. W is equal to the amount of energy, I current, R resistance and T time duration. We can put the value of I over here from Ohm's law. V is equal to IR and I is equal to V over R. I square, so we can write as V square divided by R square. By putting value in it, W is equal to V square over R square. R is cancelled with this R. So the remaining terms are V square multiplied by T divided by R. So this is another mathematical form for using electrical energy, for calculating electrical energy in the circuit. This one and this one and this one, these three terms we can use to calculate the energy supplied by the charge in seconds, time t. This equation is called the Joule's law, or we can state it as the amount of heat generated in a resistance due to the flow of charges is equal to the product of square of current I resistance R and time duration T. This is the mathematical form of Joule's law. This energy can be utilized for different useful purposes. For example, bulb converted this energy into light and heat, heater and iron into heat, and fans into mechanical energy. Usually this energy appears as heat in the resistance. This is the reason that we get heat when current passes through a heater. The next topic is the electric power. In general, we know that the power is the work done divided by time. It is the ratio between time and work done. If two different persons have the different capability of doing work, so their time of work done will be different. For electrical power, we can say that the amount of work done can be replaced as the amount of energy supplied by current in unit time is known as electric power. Here power can be determined by the formula power is equal to electrical energy divided by time. Electrical energy is written as here work done by the current. Power is equal to work done divided by time. As we know that the electrical energy is equal to charge into voltage, by putting value P is equal to QV divided by T. As we know that Q over T is equal to I, by putting this value P is equal to IV, this is the relation P is equal to IV. By Ohm's law, V is equal to IR, so we can put the value IR. So the new form is P is equal to I into I square into R. The SI unit for electric power is watt, that is equal to joule per second. Electrical energy is commonly consumed in very large quantity for the measurement of which joule is very small unit. Hence, a very large unit of electrical energy is needed, which is called kilowatt hour. Q Kilowatt hour can be defined as the amount of energy delivered by a power of 1 kilowatt in 1 hour is called kilowatt hour. In our houses, we consumed a large amount of heat and energy that cannot be calculated and measured in the smaller unit, that is joule. So we need a larger unit, that is kilowatt hour. Kilowatt hour means that we consumed 1 kilowatt energy is used for complete 1 hour, then it is equal to the one unit, that is called 1 kilowatt hour. Energy can be calculated in kilowatt hour. For that, we have to know about the power in watts, and that power uses in hours, time of use in hours divided by 1000. This is the formula to calculate the energy in kilowatt, and by this formula we can calculate the number of units that we are used. If we know the number of units and the cost of one unit, we can find the cost of electricity by using relation. Cost of electricity is equal to number of units consumed multiplied by cost of one unit. Cost of electricity is equal to number of units, we can calculate by this formula, power in watts multiplied by time of use in hours divided by 1000 into cost of one unit. The energy in kilowatt hour can be obtained by the following formula. This formula is written over here. The electric meter installed in our houses measures the consumption of electrical energy in the units of kilowatt hour, according to which we pay our electricity bills. If the cost of 1 kilowatt hour, that is one unit, is known, we can calculate the amount of electricity bill by the following formula. This is the formula written over here. We can calculate the cost of electricity by this relation. Cost of electricity is equal to power in watts, time of use in hours divided by 1000 multiplied by cost of one unit.